indications of open fractures in that injury to the neurovascular bundle, and if the fracture is threatening to penetrate the skin when there is a non-union and fracture near acromioclavicular joint, then floating shoulder, soft tissue interposition, and displaced epiphysis in children. So, this is a method of the internal fixation, that is with the K wire. Rigid plate and screw fixation with AO semitubular or pelvic reconstruction plate, and X-ray showing the fracture of the clavicle plate fixation. Then the complication of fracture clavicle are neurovascular injury may be immediate due to the direct force or delayed due to a very large canal. The structures commonly injured are subclavian vessels and the medial cord of the brachial plexus through which the ulnar nerve is derived. These occurs in the fractures of the middle one-third of the clavicle, which is the most common. So, neurovascular injury is the most important complication of the fracture of the clavicle, may be immediate due to direct force. So, it is occurred due to the direct force or delayed due to the very large callus. When there is a very large callus, then neurovascular injury is also occur in a delayed case. The structures commonly injured are subclavian vessels and the medial cord of the brachial plexus, so through which the ulnar nerve is derived. These occur in the fractures of the middle one-third of the clavicle, which is the most common. So, the ulnar nerve is the commonest nerve to be injured in the fracture of the clavicle due to its compression between it and the first rib. So, ulnar nerve is present in between the first rib and the clavicle. So when the fracture of the clavicle is occur, then ulnar nerve is injured. So malunion, it is very common due to the difficulty in holding the fracture fragments in position. Because of the distracting forces already explained, and it causes only a cosmetic problem. And does not usually impair functions, hence no treatment is required. So, malunion is very common due to difficulty in holding the fracture fragment in position because of distracting forces already explained, and it causes only a cosmetic problem and does not impair the function, since no treatment is required. So, the problems caused by malunion clavicle are cosmetic complaints, which are mentioned, orthopedic complaint, that is frequent episode of the shoulder fatigue, sleep problem, the patient complains of inability to sleep on sites, and neurological problems, that is features of thoracic outlet syndrome. So, So when there is a malunion of the clavicle, there is a cosmetic complaints, orthopedic complaint, and sleep problem, and the neurological complaint. So remedy remedies faced with these situations are the patient requires corrective osteotomy and rigid internal fixation with medullary pins or plate and screws. So the non-union is rare and require open reduction, internal fixation and bone grafting. So the remedy is facing this situation and the patient requires corrective osteotomy. So it is rigid internal fixation with medullary pins or plate and screw. Quick facts are fractured clavicle in the most common fracture in the children. Then common mode of injury is direct. . 80% break at the junction of the middle and distal third. In nearly all the fractures are treated close. Open reduction for specific indications. Malunion is a rule but no functional disability. So the non-union is rare and require open reduction. Non-union of clavicle. And it requires then open reduction, internal fixation and bone grafting. And mostly the fractured clavicle is seen in children. It is due to direct injury and 18% break at the junction of the middle and distal third. Then nearly all the fractures are treated close. Open reduction for specific indications and malunion is a rule but no functional disability. Then injuries of the acromioclavicular joint. Acromioclavicular joint, that is ACM joint, is a diarthroidal joint with a fibrocartilaginous disc between the two bones, that is similar to the meniscus. So acromioclavicular joint injury, that is ACM joint, is a diarthroidal joint with the fibrocartilaginous disc between the two bones, that is similar to a meniscus. Acromioclavicular joint is that it is essential plane joint. It permits a gliding rotation between the clavicle and the scapula. So this is a gliding rotation of the clavicle and the acromial process of the scapula. So its structural integrity depends on the intrinsic scapular ligament element and the superior acromioclavicular ligament and the extrinsic coracoclavicular ligament, which form a hood over the interval between the coracoid process and the acromion. So incidence is 12% and is common in young, that is male is to female ratio is 5:1. So the common name for ACL injury, There is acromioclavicular joint injury is a shoulder separation. ACL injury are 4 to 5 times more common than the sternoclavicular injury. Then the mechanisms of the injury is, then there is a direct force, that is, it is the most common mechanism. So these diagrams showing the most common mechanism of injury to the ACM joint of injury as in RTA, road traffic accident, assault, athletes, event, like in the track meet. So this is a injury due to the direct force. So which is seen in this diagram. It is the injury of the ACM joint. Then indirect force is due to the fall on the outstretched hand. Downward indirect force through the upper extremity is relatively rare. Clinical features shows that the patient complains of pain, swelling, and difficulty in raising the arm up. The patient supports the affected shoulder by holding elbow with unaffected hand. On examination, there is a tenderness of lateral end of the clavicle is predominantly felt. So this diagram shows the ACM injury, that is acromioclavicular joint injury, with the clinical appearance. So this is the mechanism of injury, in that when direct force is applied, there is a injury to the ACM joint, injury as in RTA, assault, and athletes event like the tackling, and it may be due to the indirect force, that is due to the fall on the outstretched hand. Is due to the fall on the outstretched hand and downward indirect force to the upper extremity is relatively rare. And clinical features are, the patient complains of pain, swelling, difficulty in raising the arm up, and the patient support of affected shoulder by holding the elbow with unaffected hand. And on examination, there is tenderness and lateral end of the clavicle is predominantly felt. So this diagram showing the acromioclavicular joint injury with the clinical appearance. Then the classification of it, that it is based on the injuries to the acromioclavicular and coracoclavicular ligament. The diagram of this, it shows that acromioclavicular joint, that is first one, this, where the ruptured acromioclavicular ligament, that is ACL, and two, in this there is a ruptured coracoclavicular ligament. That is CCL. And type 1, in that there is a minor sprain to the acromioclavicular ligament. Type 2, where there is a rupture of the acroclavicular ligament and sprain of the coracoclavicular ligament. In type 3, both ACL and CCL are ruptured. and clavicle is displaced upward. And in type 4, same as in type 3, but with upward and posterior displacement of the clavicle. And in type 5, type 3 with severe displacement of the clavicle toward the base of the neck. And in type 6, there is an inferior dislocation of the clavicle towards the base of the neck. So when we see this diagram, this is the scapula, this is the sternum, this is the clavicle, and this is the acromion process of the scapula. So when there is a ruptured acromioclavicular ligament, then it is formed is here, and in this position there is a ruptured coracoclavicular ligament. So today we stop here and have a good day, students.